From here, you're going to come up here to the main text. This main text is the same text that is actually going to be on the front of your website and also on your buyer's page. So when I click on this, that brings us to the website that we're building. And you're going to scroll on down. You're going to see this right here? This is the exact same thing that is right here. Okay. So for you to customize this home page, I would come over here and I can type whatever I want. Click save. And then guess what happens when I click refresh? This is what populates. Perfect. All right, so you're going to be able to see that. Now watch what happens. This is the exact same information that's on the home page that is on the buyer's page. So you want to make sure, see that? So you want to make sure that whatever you put on your home page on your eEdge website also pertains to when buyers come to the buyer's page. Okay? Kind of keep that in your mind of what needs to be done. All right? So when you come back over here and you want to write something or do something in here, as long as it's on this main text, this is this text that's going to be on your home page and also on your buyer's page. Now let me show you a couple things that you can do on your home page or basically on any of these pages now. I'll show you, number one, how to add an image to one of your pages here. All right, and the best way to do that, and the only way really to do that, you're going to have to add an image to your website by coming up here to the Create Marketing, and you're going to go ahead and click on that main center there. And you're going to come on over here where it says Image Manager. This is where you're going to upload your image, and it's going to give you a URL that is on your website. So it'll be safe and something that you'll be able to use. So go ahead and click on Image Manager. And this is where you're going to go ahead and you're going to upload the file or the image that you need to upload. Now, just to let you know, it's important to use your images and use the pictures and the photos that you've taken. Okay, so we don't want to be taking other people's images and or their property. So make sure that you're out there taking those pictures and using them on your website, not others. So you're going to come up here to choose file. And let's say that I want to go ahead and add an image onto my website. What you're going to do is you're going to come on over here and you're going to pick one of the images that you want to put into the system. And we're going to go ahead and just for fun, we'll just go ahead and use this Facebook image that we had created. And we're going to come over here and click open. We're going to give the image a category. We're going to give the category a name. So these are going to be social media images, and we're just going to click on upload. So these images could be images of homes, we could be images of anything you want. So like for instance, I'm going to come back here and I'll add another image. I'm going to add an image of a house. So you select the picture of the house that you want to display and click open. And what you're going to do is you're going to go ahead and click on upload. So now I've got a couple of images in here. I've got an image of a house and I've got a social media image. And I can edit those if I'd like to by clicking on the name of that. So what is this one? What is the category of this one? This is going to be houses, and I'm going to click save. So now it is the house category and the social media image category. Come on over here. If I want to delete these, I can. Now watch what happens. For me to be able to upload these images, and so, for instance, I want to upload one of these first images. I'm going to click on this social media button, and it's going to give me this image. You can see right here, when I right-click and save or copy the URL, now what I can do when I open it up in a new window and I paste it, I could click Enter, and you'll see this is the image that I've just uploaded. I'm going to need this URL or this link to be able to upload it onto my website. So I'm going to come back here and close this. And we're going to go back to admin, and we're going to go back to your website. We're going to come over here to your main text, and we're going to add an image right below this. And we're going to come up here to insert edit image. Click on that. And it's going to say, what is the source? Well, guess what? We have just uploaded that image to our website. And so the source is the URL. Remember when I came up here and I pasted this URL up here? I did that for a reason. So I can come back here now and copy that. And I'm going to come back over here and I'm going to say, this is the source. And I'm going to click in the space here. And you'll see now there's the dimensions of it. What is the description? Facebook logo. And if I want to change the description, if I want to change the dimensions, I'm going to come over here and I'll say 100. Now what happens is if I do not click in a different box, this will say 100 by 99, but it's actually 300 by 99. It'll be messed up. And even though I have this marked as basically keeping it in the proper proportion, if I don't click out of these boxes, it's not going to change it. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this and watch what happens here. It just changed the proportion because I had this marked right here. If I didn't mark it, watch. When I mark it and I change this back to 300 and I click outside of the box here, it stays at 33. So we want to make sure that we keep it in the right dimension and then we keep it right here. So that's how you're supposed to do it. Keep it here on constrain the proportions, and then make sure when you change one thing, mark outside of the box so it changes it. So that's how you're going to do it. And then all you need to do is click OK. And now you have this image in your website. Now I'll show you one other thing that you're probably going to want to do on images, something like some in images like this. What you'll probably want to do is you'll want to make it a hyperlink or a clickable link. And so if we're in this case, since this is a Facebook logo, we're going to want to link this Facebook logo to our Facebook page, our business page. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and open up my Facebook business page. What you're going to do is you're going to come up to your business page URL and you're going to copy that. And you're going to come back over here and you're going to click on the image so it looks just like this. You're going to come on over here to where this hyperlink button is. You're going to click on that button and you're going to paste that link and it's going to say text to display. Now the important thing is you don't want to fill out the text to display, because if you click text to display, your image isn't going to be displayed. You want to make sure the image is displayed. So leave that blank. You're going to come over here to target and it says you've got two options, either none or new window. New window is used for times when you're going to be sending somebody away from your website. So for instance, Facebook, that business page is away from your website and you want it to populate or pull up in a new window, not in the same window. And I'll show you an example of what that looks like. For when it's none, this is when you're actually sending navigation from one part of your website to another part of their website. So I'll show you real quick both examples. Facebook image is going to be a new window. And you're going to go ahead and click OK. Now we have that image that's clickable. Now I'm going to show you something else. We could do the same thing for hyperlinks. It doesn't have to be an image. You could actually just type in words and you're going to highlight the images just like you did highlight the pictures. And you're going to come up here where it says insert link. And you're going to go ahead and put the URL for searching for homes on your website. So we're going to come up here. And since this is the buy page, this is going to be the URL we're going to copy. We're going to come back here and we're going to paste the URL of the site that we want to go to. And since this is a navigation within our website and we don't want it to populate in another window, it's okay to put that text display there because it's not an image. But then also we're going to, when it comes to your target, it's not going to be a new window, it's going to be none. And then you're going to click OK. And then we're going to go ahead and click Save so you can see the differences between the two. So when I go ahead and go back to the home page, I scroll on down here and I'm going to see two things. this image that I can click on. And when I click on this, because it's a Facebook business page, it's going to bring me away from my website, and I don't want that to happen. So watch what happens when I click this. It opens up a whole new window so I can come back here and still see my website. Now what happens is if I did not do it where it was new window and I clicked, watch this, search for homes, it actually navigates it within the same window to that website page. So what happens is I don't want to remove people away from my website. I want to keep them where they're at. So if you're sending them away from your website, make sure that you're doing the feature where you are opening it in the new window. Okay? So then did you see how I did that? When I come back here and see where it says search for homes, when I click search for homes, all this is navigating them to a place inside of my website. Pretty cool? All right, so that is how you're able to add images, content to a page, and also hyperlinks. And this is for the main text.